Guys, welcome to a very, very special monthly update for me because I've got some huge news on the house front, which I'll share with you shortly. But before we get there, let's not forget why I do this video. This is a thank you video, which I've been doing now since 2011, even before Worth a Buy. I was doing this on my other channel, my little Let's Play channel. And I do it to say thank you. That's it. I've got to say thanks. And this is my way of doing it. And if it takes us a day out of my week to do the video, or it takes about half a day to do this video, then it's a half a day well spent to say thank you to everybody. So let's start with the PayPal people. We've got Cameron Kirby, Martin Pinter, Paul Bibley, Christopher Lowry says, cheers, mate, just listening to your monthly update now. This is to pay for Evil Genius 2. Oh, shit. Skip that, Mac. Joshua, Amy X, Brandon Cook, David Lang, Thomas Bator. After 4 years, I skipped a month on Patreon due to card issues. Fixed now, hopefully, so here's a bonus. Cheers. Aaron McGill, thanks for your reviews. Appreciate it. Theodore Bock, Gilneum Lunan, Corey Simmons, Carl Smith. If I butcher your name, I'm not just taking the piss out of you. I don't know. My tongue just won't allow me to say. I can't do it. Sorry. Raymond Brush, David Verstran. Keep up the good work, Mac. I don't always agree with what you say. Well, of course, it's opinions, isn't it? But I don't need to realise that when it comes to game reviews, you're an expert that can continue to offer valuable specific insights about games, even if you hate other parts of them. Yeah, just waiting on the Oddworld review. CY Design, Dave Carey, Peter Hogg, Neil Bate, Jim Gillard, Svensson 3000, Kyron Kateney, I totally wrecked that name. Louis Kennedy, if you're looking for another game to review, I recommend checking out the latest squad build. It's awesome. Brian Halmond, thanks for being an awesome and genuine mate. I hope one day you do a review of a game called Sudoku 2. All the games to follow it weren't even half as good. I never even got to play Sudoku 1, but I've seen that it was universally amazing and you could load your save file from Sudoku 1 onto Sudoku 2. Seriously, such an amazing game. It's a story like none else. 100-ish playable characters. First game I've played that your choices impact the story. I'll have a look at that. Ruben Angelov, Rice Thorburn, Robert McPherson. Hi, Mac. Trying to help reduce the stress levels and donating a few bob towards the new house. Taylor, love your channel, mate. Good luck with the hoose. Integrity Personal Training, Michael Hartman. Thanks for the awesome Valheim review. I'm absolutely loving the game. We've been in a gaming drought for far too long, but it's games like Valheim that come around every so often that remind me of the good old days. Love the content. Keep up the good work. And we've got Greg Jesham. Hi, Mac, long-time subscriber. No idea how long you've been at this gig, but I'd guess I've been hip to you for about 10 years plus now. Never given you a cent outside my commercial views, though, which I feel guilty for. I don't need to feel guilty. Everybody has the reasons for not donating. And the reason I'm giving you a small lump sum now. You're the best, and I appreciate everything you do. Thank you, and know there's many people like me who have loved you for years and never reached out. We suck. Hear that? You suck. Dodger Greg, P.S. If I may ask one question, and I'm behind on the topic, is Pantheon ever going to come out? Well, I have no idea. Joseph Sanger, I'm a student, so I'm not rich, but I love your videos, and while I often enjoy the games you dislike, I can't deny you're pretty much always on point with your criticisms. Just a small something for now, but I hope when I have a bit more money, I can support you more. I hope you get a really good job when you graduate and give me lots. Philip Caps, just got my bonus, so here's your cut. I don't need a cut of your bonus, but thank you very much. Hope you enjoy the new hoose. More news on that shortly. Mark Bates, sorry mate, just seen the monthly update and give me a prod to donate this month. Well, that's not why I do the monthly update, but thanks anyway. I've been a bit busy and it slipped my mind. By the way, if you can play Resident Evil Maiden demo on the PS5, I can't get my hands on a PS5. If you know anyone with it, it's fantastic. Reminds me of Phasmophobia. Ooh. Anyway, keep up the hard work and looking forward to your new reviews coming this month. And then finally we have Gattus Jacob McMullen, Hector Hernandez, Patrick Albarth, Michael Nash, Jacob Cole, Joshua McBride, Leon James and Clay Hoyle. Clay, thanks. I'm going to roll the patron names now, guys, and we're going to talk a little bit about the house. But first, a huge thank you to all my patron donators. Loads of them on there. I think it's about 800. Most of them are $1 ones, obviously. But, you know, $1 might not sound much. It's about 75 pence. But, you know, for the work I do in a month, I think I'm worth a dollar, guys. And but they all add up. And, you know, I've got a few hundred people give a dollar. So that's a few hundred pounds that come in of all of them people putting together. It's like ants, isn't it? A little ant's useless on its own. But when it's a huge colony, they can take down huge predators and all. Mac, what are you talking about ants? It's just I've been watching ant videos. So huge thank you. A huge thank you to everybody who donates through whichever platform, whether it be me streams, Subscribestar, buying games on Green Man Gaming after clicking the links in the description, whatever it is, a huge, huge thank you. Because you've bought me a house, guys. It's as simple as that. I've had the go-ahead. My mortgage has been accepted, my mortgage application. So it's on. It's all in the hands of solicitors now. We're just waiting for a completion date and then I move in. And it can't come soon enough. This place we're in now is so depressing. Cass didn't even go for a walk on her own. We're having fireworks. There was one pretty much thrown at the house last night. The stolen motorbikes go past on a daily basis here. The neighbours are awful. It's Chav Central Station here. It's just, I can't wait to move out. Well, Mac, you're going to have to wait probably quite a bit longer. Yes, let me introduce myself. I am Future Mac. You see, what you've just heard, guys, was recorded on Saturday the 10th of April. It's now Tuesday the 13th, 3 days later. And what old Happy Mac there doesn't realise is the whole deal's now f***ing gone. Which is what I'm going to explain to you now. This is why you didn't get a video yesterday, by the way. Because I've just, this all kind of hit me on Sunday. And I've been just looking through contracts and forums, just getting information. So I'll tell you what's happened and then you'll understand. The house that I'm buying is fine. There's nothing wrong with that. And the woman that lives there is happy to sell it to me. The problem is, the house that she was going to move into has fallen through. And it's fallen through because of some f***ing underhandness on the behalf of the people selling it. You see, it has leased solar panels. Now, when you go to view a house, if you can't see the house from a distance because of the situation of it, you don't really see the roof because you kind of pull up next to the house, and because the houses are so high, you can't like see on the roof. So she couldn't see that there were solar panels on there. And nobody said from the estate agents, nobody said, even when she was asking them about heating the house, no one mentioned solar panels at all. But it was in small print on the description, just under the description of the house on the estate agents. And she only just found out on Sunday that it has leased solar panels. And obviously that's a big no-no. And so I was made aware of all this and I started searching for the ramifications of buying a house with leased solar panels. And it isn't good. You have a real hard job selling them. They lease your roof essentially for 25 years. And apparently these were only installed in 2014. So the contract runs all the way through till 2039. Now, she's pulled out. I don't blame her. There's no way. There's absolutely no way. So, yeah, the whole thing's off. I've even paid for a surveyor. I had a surveyor out last week. That came back great. I've even started buying stuff. Like I said, I bought a few things for the house. A couple of good posters, pictures, and lamps and stuff. Priced up a barbecue. All the priorities, guys. So I'm f***ed off. I've spent the last 2 days trawling the internet, looking at the ramifications of leased solar panels. Which is why this video hasn't gone out. Which is why my Oddworld review didn't get out yesterday either. So like I say, guys, I've just been educating myself about all of this kind of stuff. And, yeah, there it is. So I apologize to end the video on a downer. But at least you could hear how happy I was at the beginning. Life goes on. We've just got to pick ourselves up and carry on and just keep hoping that another house comes up that is the right one for the person who's in the house that we're going to buy, and that they can get a deal done soon. I've got 6 months because I've been accepted on my mortgage. I spent the whole of last week doing all these meetings and everything. Got everything done, surveyors out, everything's done. I've got 6 months now to do the deal. So we'll see what happens, guys. But as always, look, thanks for your huge support. That's what this video is about. It's about thanking everybody. And without you guys, I wouldn't even be in this position. So, you know, let's get some perspectives here. I'm still in it. It's not the end of the world. I'm still in. There's no one else going to get this house off me. I've been assured that it's mine. We just need to get a house for her to move into, and then it's back on. So we'll just see what happens, I guess. We'll just carry on. At least I'll have plenty of time now to get up back on with my reviews. So, because it has been tough the last 10 days. I've just been so busy, as you can imagine, doing all this. So I'm not in the mood today to do reviews, but I'll start up again tomorrow. I'm going out today. Going out for a drive. Might even go to the seaside. I don't know. So there you go, guys. I'll see you in the next video.